Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break
it. No, you don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move. I don't want to get in trouble. Look, I'm already grounded.
Something isn't right here,
just put
Snow.
It back exactly where it was, please.
Snow, come on. Are you kidding? It's a glamour tube. Something's going on here.
Recently used, right?
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me! The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
I'm begging you!
Maybe he's glamoured!
I don't want to get in trouble!
To look like the wall or something. Nope, I was right the first time. Knew it!
It hurts when you do it that fast.
Good.
What? Not sprightly enough?
No more bull.
You picked the wrong night to lie to me. No more lying, no more ring around the rosy, no more bullshit non sequiturs. You're done. It's over. You're gonna tell me what I wanna know right now.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
Where's...
I was born in the woods to a jackal and a deer.
Not
oh, brother,
that.
Where's Crane?
Where's Crane? Speak quickly.
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew, there's nothing I know that would help.
Why are you protecting him?
Why, in the name of everything holy, are you protecting this weaselly scumbag? I mean, what on earth could he have done to deserve this kind of loyalty?
Crane could be hollow bones tomorrow, and you wouldn't see me cry a drop. But that doesn't mean I can tell you anything. You have friends, don't you? Well, I don't want Crane's friends for enemies.
Who are you protecting?
If you're not protecting Crane, who are you protecting?
Get this through both of your skulls. I can't tell you. Just you being here is bad enough.
She ensorcelled?
There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something, you have to forget it.
We can protect
you. This is more important.
Is it?
We can protect you, okay? Whatever it is you're afraid of, we can make sure that it won't come to pass.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Of course I know, because
okay,
you won't tell us.
You know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap. If she's afraid for her life, we can at least make sure she never hurts us again.
What are you saying?
We're destroying the tree. No!
Oh.
How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please.
Greenleaf could be useful.
Don't do this.
Isn't there another way? She's a witch. Can't she just work for us? That way she'd be official.
You want to reward her for criminal behavior? We can't trust this woman on the 13th floor.
It doesn't matter, because I'd never do it. I'm not a house cat, and I don't play well with others.
Oh, trust me, no one would confuse you for a cuddly animal.
Huh. She really doesn't like her.
Bigby, this is an order. Burn the tree.
No! Look,
an
look,
order.
I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
Oh.
He thinks it's the ring of dispel. You know, know that it will pierce the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence.
Prove his innocence?
It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago.
I'm sorry, but we still can't let you keep the tree. It wouldn't be right after what's happened.
Oh, boy.
Bigby.
Please, Sheriff.
Greenleaf, I'm hiring you.
Today's your lucky day, Greenleaf. I'm hiring you as the business office's newest witch in residence.
Bigby!
The witches over there will keep her out of trouble, and we have a glamour shortage as it is. It makes the most sense now. You get to keep your fucking tree.
Snow's not gonna
just
like that.
Just don't expect me to bow down to your little woman here.
That's not my little woman.
Don't think for a second that this is over.
So what? Are moving trucks gonna show up here or something?
Something like that.
We'll call you.
Alright, before she starts screaming at us, let's see what the new entry or entries is. Yeah. Auntie Greenleaf, the white deer, horticulturist, alchemist, and a lover of animals, Auntie Greenleaf is one of the few rogue witches still living outside of the 13th floor, unsupervised and unrestricted. Rumored to have lost a daughter in the homeland, she suffers paranoia and depressive mood swings, and will only venture outside at irregular hours under the guise of an ethereal white deer, an oft-whispered specter of Brookhaven natives. Glamour tube, the handy disguise. Glamours can be produced in a variety of ways. Oh, she lost her daughter. I just caught that. So the daughter in the photo, she glamoured herself to look like her daughter was lost. So we never would have found a kid there. Glamours can be produced in a variety of ways, but one of the most common, due to its ease of use, is to take a small, hollowed-out tube or container and place within it several items unique to whomever the caster wants to copy. A witch is required for the reactionary charm. Two downsides of this type of glamour is the totally unique appearances are completely impossible, and the nature of the vessel makes it quite unstable. Okay. One, two, three, four. I only got four more to go. Let me guess, I'm only gonna find three. Keep missing one of the fable entries. It's annoying. But there you go. Wooden pie. Here we are.
That's Crane's car.
I was gonna say take a back way in, but no.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss a spot? Mr. Clean come to smash up the rest of my place.
Yep.
Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
No. Where's Crane?
Where's Crane?
Ichabod Crane. What would that nerd have with a place like this?
You tell me.
Tell me what you know, now!
That would be him. Nice try.
Hey, you can't just go in there.
Watch us.
We have a problem.
Tell me who did it, just tell me who did it! I know you know!
Mr. Crane, please, she
He's...
can't help-
I know you know what the-
Sorry to interrupt in the middle, but he, I bet you, he's just calling the Tweedles right now, saying, we have a problem. That's who he's calling.
The plan is, I won't be held accountable for this.
Grab Crane.
I can't. I'm sorry.
Grab him.
Oh my god.
Hi.
Wait, don't.
I was gonna punch him, that's all.
I didn't do anything. I promise you, I didn't do anything. These girls, the girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get this stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over!
Now, I'm sorry to keep interrupting, but yet, if what the Auntie Greenleaf is saying is true, the ring lets them speak the truth. So if he was guilty, he would not want to use that ring. Of course, he knows it would still... He doesn't know it's not working. But if he wants to pull the truth out of them, then apparently he didn't do it. I'm a little confused, so let's see what happens.
That's all, please. I'm innocent, completely, completely innocent.
The ring won't work.
Let me show you.
The ring won't work. Greenleaf sold you out.
What? No. This will work. I assure you. It must.
Yeah, I assure you.
I went to...
Oh, Green Lantern. By the power of Green Lantern.
Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed.
Are they in Sorcel then? Sorry. Now we got an entry. Might help us figure out what's going on. Oh, the ring. Ring of Dispel, the Arthurian ban, reputed to be fashioned by a Byzantine clan in an attempt to ward off a coven of witches. The Ring of Dispel, or Dispelling Ring, or Magic Canceling Ring, eventually was given to Lancelot by the Lady in the Lake. Okay, it's a dispel magic thing. So these girls are obviously have a spell around them that they cannot say who did it. Who killed them? Which makes me wonder, because I thought there was a spell like that on Lady Greenleaf, but then she was able to tell us where he went. So, I don't know. Recovered by the business office after the emigration to New Amsterdam, it was assigned to Greenleaf for caretaking. And then lost its charge, I guess, over the ages. Felt like a bag of rocks.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many. But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that.
Weren't you there?
Oh, God.
We found the photos.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know. I just love you, Snow. I love you, and I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay?
I'm got that
sorry
right.
I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love.
I think he'd be old enough to know better. Especially,
Baby?
They're all centuries old or something.
I don't think he did it.
What?
Yeah,
look
I don't...
at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women?
I don't think so either.
He's not... He's gonna... be brave enough not to put his stamp on the world like that. He's a disgusting coward, not a murderer.
I'm gonna say nothing, because...
It means so much to...
Shut up. Don't talk to me.
I pretty much know he didn't do it. He's going to use the ring to prove his innocence, so which means he
you
does.
You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown, of using our money for his own ambitions. That's one thing. But
yeah.
Don't you have doubts he's a murderer?
We've I do.
We've known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
Yes, I know how this.
Why would he even come here if he wasn't covering his tracks?
He's trying
he
to get his innocence out.
And maybe he is.
This fuck-up knows more he knows, than
he's saying. He knows more, that's
when... I don't!
Yes, okay, he probably does. But there's a difference between being involved and being the guy who did it.
Okay, but if Crane didn't kill Faith and Lily, I'm sorry, but who the hell did?
Maybe the butcher. Who's the butcher?
You know, when I saw you come back here, I thought this was over.
Now, I know, and I'm sorry, but
if the killer's still out there, I want to know who it is.
We'll find out.
We'll find out who did it soon enough. Just trust us, Vivian.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
You've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We're not gonna kill you, so quit your shivering.
Tell him.
Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses, but as of right now, you're coming with us.
Using an illegal glamour. Get up.
Get the fuck up. Now,
I guess we know who's in charge, Sheriff.
Sometimes it's fuzzy.
Yeah, well, it's a give and take.
You think you have what it takes to run that office?
At least I got steel funds.
Sacrifices. I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me.
If I maybe took a little something back in return, then so be it.
I have no regrets.
You're going to prison.
Better save your energy, huh? You're going away for a long time.
So who's the killer? Is it someone we've met yet, or someone we have yet to meet? Like, who's the butcher? We're gonna be intercepted by the Tweedledum and Tweedledee, aren't we?
Stupid girls and preposterous schemes.
What are you saying?
They're always showing up whenever we don't want them to. Don't expect them to. I expect it now, though. Hi! Is that their car? On the stairs. Crane is... Is he trying to get away? This is a dead end. Well, we could keep running back and forth. Oh, there's more than one car. Okay, never mind. Yep, here's the Tweedles right on time. And someone else. Who's this?
Hi. What you got there?
Is that the butcher?
Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're... How shall I put this? Attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120-odd pounds. Pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now, not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking. Guys?
Who are you?
Who are you?
No, 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 no. That's not how this works.
I'm making it work that way.
How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here. Like a good doggy.
I think not.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up.
Get him.
You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Just gonna get out.
Tweedledee. What's the, you know, that thing the Mundys call me?
The Butcher?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Butcher.
Bloody Mary.
That's it.
Oh, Bloody Mary.
And do you know why they call me that?
You killed
because
your
some of them
parents?
Think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog.
You should meet Candyman.
And I do that for a hobby. Like golf. To relax. This is my job. I like my job.
Crane is in my custody.
What I'm gonna do to you, your girl, and the rest of your friends if you don't hand over the sock puppet now.
He's in custody, so move your car.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Well, he's right.
Fuck it.
Oh. I couldn't avoid that? Did I miss something? I only saw one cue. I hate the way they smile like that. It hurts. Yeah. Get up, Bigby. Oh, transform. You guys got any more shells left? I'm still hitting it, but... Okay. Oh, I'm supposed to push continuously forward, right? Am I supposed to tap it? Am I supposed to be doing this a different way, or is it supposed to go this slowly? Hey, you better run. Throw him at the other one. Next. Nice. Incoming.
Fuck you, wolf.
Let him go. Throw him too. Don't change back or anything, just let him go. And let Tweedledum live. That girl's got a gun, so. Should I not? Ow. Ah, damn.
It was a good show, but, you know, it just didn't know when to end.
If I had killed him, would I be able to continue? That's the woodsman's axe. Isn't it?
You know,
oh, I can get up?
Silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But, as it turns out, it's just...
Oh no, I'm losing! I'm not
great.
Doing it any slower!
I mean, hey, look, I know it's...
Okay, I'm gaining. This is killing me!
Can you argue with these results?
I'm full. Nope.
Because I know
halfway.
I can't.
Wait! Stop! Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Don't do this.
No. Don't do this.
Who's in the car? I got a Book of Fables entry here. Probably about Bloody Mary. Is she the one who killed... the two of them? Faith and Lily, of course. Bloody Mary, the urban legend. The true history of the person known as Bloody Mary is almost completely unknown. Even to Fable's most acquainted with its members, her name Mary, at least, is not up for contention, nor is her penchant for shocking violence, an inlaid resistance to magic and spells, really. And a strange ability to use any reflective surface as a portal, effectively shortcutting space and time. Thought by Mundy's to be the wailing apparition of a childless ghost, though any evidence of that is as yet unseen. I got two more entries. Now, who's in the car? Maybe that's
lucky day, kid.
The butcher.
Crooked man says it's okay with him.
What's the crooked man?
Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach ache?
Hmm.
Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended.
You figure that out. Thanks.
Kinda like your boyfriend here. Too pussy to ruin a Tweedlesday.
Oh! Oh my god.
A beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen. I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
Yeah, I can't wait to get my claws in you. His whole bone sticking out. We missed two fable entries. Two this time.
He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
Yeah,
this is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
Okay.
I'll get things under control. Woody, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What do you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
After what they did to you, are you even gonna be able to stop them?
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point, do you?
Wow. Well, the episodes keep getting shorter and shorter. Barely over an hour and a half this time. Did you interrupt Snow's eulogy? 80.7% of players decided not to interrupt Snow. What place did you investigate first? Well, it's almost tied between Crane's apartment and the Tweedledum and Tweedledee? Is that what this is? Or that their place? Oh no, I couldn't see, make out what that was. Okay, it was almost half and half between the bar, you know, with Holly, and Crane's apartment. Really, in the minority was Tweedledum and Tweedledee, which I wanted to see just for myself, but I figured that's not going to help us get to where we want to go by 2 a.m. We were still late anyway. Did you make a deal with Jack? Really? We're in the minority there for the first time, pretty much. 29% of players decided not to make a deal. I was too pissed off at the moment. Did you burn Greenleaf's tree? 79.5% of players did not burn Greenleaf's tree. Did you kill Tweedledum? 55.8% of players showed Tweedledum mercy. Almost half. Cut down the middle. Almost half the people just killed him. Of course, Tweedledum is the one we hadn't really dealt with other than him punching us in the face the first episode. He was there, you know, harassing us at the funeral as well. That's it. All right. So curiouser and curiouser. So still, we've got some new characters in the mix. Who's the crooked man? Is that the one of the entries we're missing for the episode 3? Did the crooked man kill Faith? And or Lily? Or did he have Bloody Mary kill one or both of them? Laura Bailey. Pretty sure I know who Laura Bailey is. I just can't remember. I mean, as far as voice acting. So maybe, apparently the Tweedles are working for the Crooked Man, not, what's his name, Ichabod Crane. I don't think Crane had anything to do with it, really. He probably knows something about the Crooked Man and Bloody Mary, though, and like why they want him. I just don't know why specifically why they want him. Maybe just because he knows things about them. Before I go, I just want to... The person's pet name is No. Imagine yelling at the... scolding the pet. No! No! I want to double check the entries and see if there's something I'm missing. Another entry unlocked. No. I hit that? I mean, I hit that. Bothers me. Yeah, and I'm missing two of these. Damn it. Yeah, I hope at the end we get to look at the uncovered ones. I mean, the ones that have not been uncovered. It keeps saying new because... yeah, achievements. Completed chapter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the episode in general. I wonder what I keep missing. It really annoys me because I go out of my way to discover all content, except for that part where we had to rush to get to the Greenleafs by 2 a.m. So I felt I had to, you know, kind of hurry up, you know? We were still late. I wonder if we could have gotten there on time. I'm gonna have to watch, like, a Let's Play after this and see how things differed. Anyway, well, thank you guys so much for watching. I am very much enjoying this. I'm say... out of the Telltale games, yeah, I like it. Pretty much, I'd say, equally as the first Walking Dead game, and that's a lot coming from me. Definitely more than the other Walking Dead seasons, definitely more than Guardians of the Galaxy, and, what do you call it? Game of Thrones, and the two Batman ones, and that's all the ones I played. So, I am eager, very eager to see how this turns out. Hope you guys are enjoying, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Always, seek adventure.